With the people of the world speak many different languages to express our feelings. We exchange our feelings with other people with the help of a language. But the language which is spoken since one's childhood, that is called one's mother tongue or mother language. So everybody, if every person in the world wants to speak in his mother language, then it will be quite unknown to other people of other nation. That is why we have to speak in a common language that is understood all over the world. In this regard, English has an important place that has connected the whole world. That is why English is called a linking language. It's a library language. It's a window language. In this regard, we must have accurate knowledge of grammar. Then we can exchange our views and feelings without any mistake. And if we speak correctly, then people will understand it very well. So we have to know the basic structure of sentence. Now I'd like to say what is a sentence. So if we say that a sentence is a group of words that has a sense, it is not a good definition, because a group of words may not be a sentence, because a group of words must have a complete sense together, then it will be a correct sentence in English. So if we want to know a sentence, then we must say that A sentence is a group of words that has a complete sense or meaning. Example, in this regard, we can say that the dog is a faithful animal. The dog is a faithful animal. Again, we can write, people speak English all over the world. I have written here two sentences, and all these two sentences express their meaning in full. That is why these are good examples of sentences. But if somebody arranges the word in a disorder manner, that means if somebody arranges the words of this sentence, speak people English all world over the. So all the words which are present here, these words are also present here. So but this is a correct sentence, but this speak people English all world over the, it can never be a correct sentence, because the words are not or placed in an orderly manner. In an orderly manner with the rule of grammar. So if we want to write a sentence in English, then we have to follow the basic structure like this.
subject plus verb. Then other words. We must keep these two places intact to make a good sentence in English.
Then, if somebody wants to write it differently, then it will never become a sentence, because all the words in such sentences, all the words in such groups will not give a complete sense. If the words in a group does not give the complete sense, then it can never be a sentence, because it does not have any meaning. So to become a sentence, one must place subject, verb and other words in an orderly manner or a grammatical sequence. That is why I am discussing this topic of grammar, sentence. This is the primary need for our children and all those who want to speak in English and get some benefits by speaking English and want to visit some foreign countries and exchange. Sometimes people want to visit the foreign countries, but they get difficulty in exchanging their views and feelings with other people. But if we learn English in a proper way, then we can have contact with the people all over the world, because it's the linking language. Everybody knows it. English is a linking language. So when we use sentences, or we speak in many different ways. But English grammar has allowed us to speak in five different ways. It will be enough if we can speak in five different ways. And the ways in which we should speak are classified as the kinds of sentences. So as the kinds of sentences, the grammar has classified sentences as, I am writing here on the whiteboard, kinds of sentences. You can see here clearly, the first kind of sentence is assertive sentence. Assertive sentence or statement or declarative sentence. So when we speak about this sentence, we have to say that when we describe something, we give the description of a place, of an animal or other things, then it becomes an assertive sentence. So when we exchange in an ordinary manner with other people, when we exchange in ordinary manner with other people, but by not questioning or not by ordering or requesting, then we use this type of sentence. This is called an assertive sentence. So an assertive sentence is a sentence which is used for describing a thing or narrating a thing. So there are so many examples of assertive sentences. We can write like this: India is a vast country. We can write India is a vast country. Moreover, we can write that Assam produces a lot of tea. So the tea of Assam is world famous, everybody knows it. That is why I have written this sentence. So these sentences describe about something. So this describes about India, Now again, this sentence describes about Assam's tea. So in this way, these are the examples of assertive sentences. Again, we can write the second kind as interrogative sentence. Interrogative sentence. So now we can gauge an interrogative sentence from its name. Interrogation, that means the sentence which is always used for asking question or interrogation. The name itself signifies its action. So the sentence which is used for questioning or asking something from somebody or asking somebody for something, such type of sentences are called interrogative sentences. So you can write, what is your name? Very simple example. What's your name? What's your name? How old are you? How old are you? This type of interrogative sentences always ask question. Where are you from? Where are you from? Where are you from? Are you watching my video? I can ask you, are you watching my video? This will also be an interrogative sentence. Are you watching my video? Are you subscribing my videos? This will be also an interrogative sentence. So such type of sentences are used for asking question only. So it is very important to know, to know question, how to ask question, because in between our conversation, we not only describe anything or anybody or any place. We have to ask, otherwise we have to question, otherwise our lifestyle will not be fulfilled. That's why it is very important to know this interrogative sentence. Again, our speech or conversation of daily life is not limited between this assertive sentence and interrogative sentence. Another type of sentence the grammar provides or describes as an imperative sentence, because in our daily activities, in our daily life activities, we have to order something, request something, to get something, or advise somebody to do something. That is why the grammar has classified this type of sentences as an imperative sentence. So we may say, what is an imperative sentence? Already I have explained it with some examples, like some order, request, or advice. So we can say, we can advise our children like this, please study well. So this is an advice to our children. We may say like this. Sometimes I can order our servant like this, bring me a cup of tea. So this will be an order. Again, we can request somebody for something like this, please open the window. Please open the window. We can advise somebody, mind your own business. So these will be the examples of imperative sentences. So in our daily life, we use this type of sentences for exchanging our views and feelings and for our need. So sentences work like keys. Sentences work like keys, and language work like language works like soul. If we don't know language, then we cannot contact or interact with other people. Then again, our life is not limited in this among these three types of sentences. Sometimes we express our feeling very strongly. Sometimes we express our feeling very strongly, or our feelings are expressed suddenly. And if we express our feeling strongly and very suddenly, then this type of sentence and this type of expression is called an exclamatory sentence. Exclamatory sentence. I hope all of you are getting understood what I am telling you. I am telling it in a very simple and practical way. So sometimes we have to express our sudden feelings or strong feelings of mind. Then we use this type of sentence, because our life in this world has a lot of activities, full of lots of activities, and we have to work in different situations, and in different situations we react differently. Sometimes we have to express our sudden feelings like this. If we won a match, then we say, "Hooray, we have won the match. Hooray, we have won the match." At the end of this sentence, we have to put note of exclamation. Note of exclamation. Again, if we become surprised by looking at something, then we can say, "What a tall building! What a tall building!" That means it's a very tall building which I have never seen in my life. In happiness, in sorrow, in surprise, we react differently. So this type of sentence expresses those feelings of our strong feelings of our mind. That is why this sentence is called exclamatory sentence. And we have to know the proper use of this sentence to express our proper feelings. Again, there is another kind of sentence that is called an optative sentence. An optative sentence. So what is an optative sentence? It is very important to know about this sentence also, because you see, our life is not limited only in describing something, asking something, ordering or requesting somebody or something for something, or expressing our sudden feeling. Sometimes we feel the need of another expression, like blessing. We want to bless somebody, we also want to curse somebody if we don't become happy with that person. So in this regard, this sentence helps us to express our feeling very correctly or very importantly. So this kind of sentence is used for cursing, blessing, etc. like this. So generally we start or write this sentence by placing "may" before it. May you be happy. May you be happy. This is a blessing that I have given to you. Okay. May God bless you. May God bless you. I have prayed for you to God the Almighty. So this is an expression which is very common in our life. So this type of sentence is very important to know. Okay? Now we can, if I become angry with somebody, then we can write May God
May God destroy you. May God destroy you. May God destroy you.
So this is a curse because I have become angry with somebody. That is why I have written this sentence. So in this way, we can say that sentences are of five kinds, and all those sentences are very important in our daily life because we use all these types of sentences when we exchange our feelings with other people. So I hope everybody has understood sentence well, and I will be uploading videos of English grammar regularly, and please encourage me by subscribing more and more so that I can provide you this service to share my knowledge, and so that I become inspired by your subscription. So thank you. Thanks to you all. Okay.